Students, in our today's class, we are going to learn the new chapter, that is circle. Chapter 7, Circles, from your 4th standard mathematics textbook. So in this chapter, you are going to study about how to draw a circle, then draw a circle using compass, then you have to identify its center, radius and diameter. Let us begin. So you are familiar with few shapes, isn't it? You have learned triangle, rectangle, square, circles, etc. So now tell me, or let's make a list of objects which resemble a circle. Okay, so one example is already given here, that is bangle, a glass bangle. Name some other shapes, okay, or objects which has the shape or which resemble a circle. So it is wall clock, right? Wall clock, then pizza. Have you tasted pizza? What is the shape of the pizza? It is circle. Ring, your finger ring, yes. So one more example you have to write by yourself. Construction of circles. So take a bangle. Is it possible to draw a circle with itself? Yes, it is possible to draw a circle using a bangle. So list out any four objects by which you can draw a circle. So you can use a bangle, right? You can use a bangle, or you can use a coin. Yes, you can use a coin. You can use rings, right? Finger rings. So one more you have to write by yourself. Draw a circle in the blank space given by the objects which you have listed above. So use any of these objects, then you have to draw a circle here. So this activity you have to do by yourself. Join the points given. Which is the shape obtained? Observe. So you have to join these points. Okay, you have to join these points. When you join these points, what is obtained or which shape is obtained here?
Circle.
Yes, you will get a circle. So you will get circles. Open the geometry box that you have. By which instrument can you draw a circle? Yes, we have compass in a geometry box from which we can draw a circle. This is called as a compass attached to a pencil. This is a compass. Now, I will teach you how to draw the circles using the compass. First, what you have to do, you have to fix a pencil to the compass and tighten it, okay? Fix a pencil to the compass, okay, like this. This is the metal needle. One side of the compass will have the metal needle. So, keep it on the sheet of the paper and draw a circle. You have to draw a circle. Okay, yes, this is the circle that we drawn using the compass. Now we see here, the pointer was here. We call this as, so this is the center of the circle. Center of the circle, okay. Now, when I draw a line joining the center of the circle and the end, we will call that as the radius. We call it as a radius. So I name the center of the circle as O, okay, and I'm going to mark different points on the circle, and I will name these points as A, B, C. Okay, then what I will do is I will join these points. Okay, I will join these points. Now I will join these points, okay. Now you see here, I have joined these points so that we have got the straight lines here. OA, OB, OC are the straight lines. These lines we call it as radius of the circle. These are the radius of the circle. Now, distance from here to here, O to A, is same as distance from O to B. Is also same as distance from O to A. Now, if I draw many lines here, okay, if I join these points to the circle, what happens? The distance will be same. So, remember always, all the points on the circle are equidistant from the center. All the points, you can draw as many points as possible. So, all these points are equidistant from the center. So, remember that all the points on the circle are equidistant from the center of the circle. And here, these lines OA, OB, OC, or if you draw as many lines here, we call it as radius. These are called the radius of the circle. Okay. Now, I have drawn one more circle here and I have marked the center as O. Now, I will locate various points on the circle. Okay, I will locate various points on the circle and I will name these points as P, Q, R, S. Here you can use any letters from English alphabets. Okay, here you can use any letters. So, I have marked different points. Now, what I will do is, I will join these points. So, I will join this line here. Okay. Now, let us join one more line. You see here, I have joined P and Q. This line is passing through the center point. Then, this Q and S, this line is also passing through the center line. Now tell me, what are this PR and SQ? We call them as diameters of the circle. So PR and SQ are the diameters of the circle. So these diameters will have two radius. You see here. Here from O to S, we call it as a radius. O to Q, this is also a radius, right? So, diameter divides a circle into two equal parts. If you consider the line SQ, here it is one part of the circle and here it is other part of the circle. So, diameter always divides the circle into two equal parts, okay? The point of intersection of any two diameters is the center of the circle. Now, this is one diameter and this is the other diameter. Joining at a point, that point is nothing but the center of the circle. Exercise 7.1. By considering A as the center of the circle, draw a circle. So, what you have to do is, take your compass and consider this point as the center and draw a circle. You have to draw one circle. So, this is the circle where A is the center of the circle. Draw two circles with center C and D such that they do not intersect each other. So, here you have to draw a circle and here you have to draw one more circle, but that circles must not touch each other. Okay. So, these are the two circles. Within the shape limits given below, draw the biggest circle. Okay. So, these are the biggest circle in the space limits given below. Now you know the meaning of radius, the center of the circle, and the diameter of the circle. So let us move on to the exercise 7.2. Draw a radius to this circle. So center is given. So what you have to do to draw the radius, you have to join the center and the any points on the circle. So I will consider a point here, and I will join this line using the ruler. So this is the radius of the circle. So the second one, draw a diameter to the circle. So diameter, you have to draw any line on the circle passing through the center. So passing through the center, this is the diameter. Observe the figure and fill in the blanks. The center of the circle, here it is M. Radius, you see here, radius we can consider either MR, PM or MQ. So I will write here radius MR, okay. You can consider any one of the three. Diameter, there is only one diameter to this circle, that is PQ. Total number of radii in the circle. Here, how many radii are drawn here?
Four.
One, two,
three.
How many?
Three.
There are three radii. There are three radii to this circle. Thus, we come to the end of this chapter.